Since HTML is structured, we're going to want to break it up into words and punctuation and word-like elements. And we use the special term token to mean all of those. In general, a token can refer to a word, a string, numbers, punctuation. It's the smallest unit of the output of lexical analysis. Remember, that's what we're currently working on. Mostly, tokens do not refer to white space, which is just a formal way of referring to the spaces between words. So we're going to be focusing on lexical analysis, ding, a process whereby we break down a string, like a sentence or an utterance or a web page, into a list of tokens. One string might contain many tokens in the same way that one sentence might contain many words. Here I've written six HTML tokens, given them names on the left and examples on the right. Now, the naming of tokens is a bit arbitrary. In general, though, tokens are given uppercase names to help us tell them apart from other words or variables. So here, this left angle corresponds to an angle bracket facing left, presumably. Quite sure how to draw that. The smaller end is to face. Left angle slash is a left angle bracket followed by a slash, division sign. The right angle bracket, an angle bracket facing to the right. Here's the angle. Here's the face. And the equal sign is just an equal sign. A string is going to have double quotes around it. And a word is anything else. Welcome to my webpage. Punctuation like that. Now, it turns out that the naming of tokens is not quite an arbitrary matter. You may think I'm as mad as a hatter. No, that's a different story. So we're just going to go with these token names for now. But if you're designing a system from the ground up, you can rename them to be anything you like.